Hello and welcome to this guide about the best marksman hero in Mobile Legends. At the moment, there is no single best hero. Choosing the best marksman hero depends on what kind of heroes you match up against and which heroes your allies choose. In this guide, I will teach you 5 strong marksman heroes that can all be the best hero in certain situations. You will learn when to choose this hero and in which situation you should avoid to play the featured heroes. If you're interested in the same kind of information for the other roles, consider to subscribe to the channel so you won't miss out on the future videos. Let's start right away. The first hero on this list is Granger. At the moment, he is one of the strongest marksman heroes because of his high damage. He fits very well at the jungler role, but he can also be decent when playing him at one of the lanes. Because he is able to deal very high damage to a single target, he can take out the jungle monsters quite fast. Together with a second skill, he can move quickly through the map to farm and gank. If you want to be a successful Granger player, you should learn how to aim and hit skill 1 and his ultimate. It's also important to learn when to pick Granger and when to avoid him, which I will go over in a moment. It's not very hard for an assassin to kill Granger, and therefore you should buy some defensive items as well. This will increase his sustainability, which makes him a lot stronger. If you want to learn more about Granger, I recently made a complete guide about everything you need to know. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to learn how to master this hero. So like I said, Granger's strength comes from dealing a lot of damage against a single target. To utilize this, you should pick him in the right situation. I like to choose Granger against a team of less mobile heroes, so he can easily hit his skills. If the enemy team consists of bad mobility heroes like Layla, Eudora, Nana, Franco, Bane or Hanabi, Granger can easily empty his bullets against those heroes. Also Zhask can be countered by him if you focus on killing his spawn. It's even better when your team choose heroes with strong CC skills. This makes it easy to hit the enemy heroes. Choosing Granger can be great if your allies pick heroes like Selena, Franco, Tigreal, Angela, Guinevere or Eudora. Granger benefits from the CC of his allies, but this is also his weakness from enemies. CC will ruin his combos and cancel his first skill. Therefore, be careful when the enemy team picks a lot of heroes with CC skills. You should learn in which situations Granger is the best pick. Overall, he is a very strong marksman hero and definitely one of the best ones to pick at the moment. The next hero that can also be great in certain situations is Hanabi. She is the opposite of Granger, since she doesn't deal a lot of damage against a single target, but she's able to hit multiple targets with her basic attack. This doesn't deal very high damage in early game, but can be very powerful in late game. It's very important to play safely in early game and make sure you won't fall behind. In this stage of the match, you usually fight against one or two heroes at your lane. This minimizes the effect of hitting multiple enemies. Her basic attack can hit up to 5 targets when her skill 1 is active, which is very powerful in teamfights. Like every marksman, you need a good tank or support to help you farm as efficiently as possible, while also preventing to get killed. Just play safe in early game, focus on killing the minions, and don't take too much risk. In late game, positioning is very important. Try to stay at the backline to get protection from your allies. The fighter should initiate a team fight, and then it's time to shine. Make sure to position yourself at a safe place where you're able to use your basic attack. Staying next to an obstacle can help to block that side so enemies can't attack you from there. Cast your ultimate early on and try to hit a melee hero. This will prevent him from walking, which enables you to keep using basic attack. Hanabi can be a good pick when your team has heroes that use CC and can center the enemies. She is a great pick if your team got heroes like Sicilian, Tigreal, Belleric, Jawhead, Barret and Estus. This way she has more time to use basic attack to deal high damage against all enemies. She also is strong against melee enemies. So when the enemy team consists of multiple fighter heroes, Hanabi can have an advantage. The fighter heroes can be kept at a distance by using her ultimate. Also your tank and fighter can block them from getting to the backline, so Hanabi can safely attack the enemies. She is especially powerful against the less mobile fighters like Bane, Sun, Xbarg and Balmond. The weakness of Hanabi are the very mobile heroes and heroes with a long range attack. The mobile heroes can get close easily and the long range heroes have an advantage since basic attack range isn't that high. Be careful against heroes like Ling, Fanny, Layla, Leslie, Sicilian and Basha. Overall, she is a great hero to use and she gets very strong in late game. The third hero on this list is Layla. Layla deals a massive amount of damage with her basic attack from a big distance. Therefore, she is one of the best marksmen against certain heroes. Layla has the longest basic attack range from all heroes and she also deals a good amount of damage with it. She also has 3 skills which all deal damage as well. This makes her a very offensive marksman, but she lacks of escape skills. I highly recommend you use Flicker or Purify to increase her mobility. When playing Layla, you have to stay at a big distance for 2 reasons. The first one is because of her bad mobility. The second reason is the increased damage from her passive when attacking from a long range. To be effective at playing Layla, you really need a good support or tank to keep the enemies at a distance. This is important for every marksman, but Layla is an easy target when she doesn't have proper protection. I only choose Layla when I know I can count on my tank or support and when the enemy team doesn't have heroes that can kill Layla easily. Layla isn't that strong in early game, but she gets very powerful after getting her ultimate to level 3. By leveling this skill, her basic attack range gets increased, which enables her to deal damage against the turret without getting hit. I've made a complete guide about how to use Layla a while back. If you want to master this hero, you can use the link in the description down below. Layla is very strong against heroes with low HP and heroes with a low attack range. Therefore, you can choose her against heroes like Chang'e, Hanabi, Angela, Bruno, Eudora and Cyclops. After hitting with skill 1, it's very easy to finish this kind of heroes with her basic attack. She also goes well in a team that's able to protect her. She's a good pick when you have a support hero and a tank in your team, or have multiple heroes with high HP. It's very important to get protected, so Layla is able to deal high damage from a big distance. Layla has a big weakness, and that's her mobility. Heroes that get close easily or can attack from a big distance will kill her in seconds. Be careful against heroes like Fanny, Ling, Saber, Lancelot, Sicilian and Vil. Overall, she is a very strong hero as long you have good protection with you. Hero number 4 is Garry. Garry can also be one of the best marksman heroes in certain situations. Her strength comes from her passive, which deals true damage based on the max HP of the target. You can play her as a jungler or as an offlaner. Garry also isn't that strong in early game. She needs to level up, so the cooldown of her second skill gets reduced. That's why it's also important to buy some cooldown items. Her mobility and strength will increase the less cooldown this skill has. This helps to activate her passive more often and also enables her to chase enemies or escape in dangerous situations. Another important factor of being a good carry player is aiming her first skill. This skill can slow enemies a lot, and when you manage to place it at the right spot, it gets very hard to escape from, while carry is able to deal a big amount of damage. Since her passive deals damage that's based on the max HP of the enemy, she's really strong against a team with a lot of high HP heroes. I like to pick carry when the enemy team has 3 heroes with more HP than average. That can be 2 tanks and a fighter, or 2 fighters with high HP and a tank. Carry's damage per second is higher against heroes with high HP, so try to estimate if carry is a strong pick based on which heroes the enemies pick. She is especially strong against Hylos, Beleric and Grog. Those heroes get affected a lot by her passive damage, which makes her a strong pick against him. Kerri is also a decent pick if your team can slow or stun enemies. She has a short basic attack range and therefore needs to come close to deal damage. Heroes like Selena, Estes, Nana, Beleric and Franco can help to prevent the enemy from escaping. She can be a bit weaker pick against the long range heroes and high burst damage heroes. Heroes like Layla, Leslie, Clint, Cecilian and Vale can attack from a safe distance, while heroes like Hayabusa, Helkert, Lancelot and Selena can take out Kerri quickly. If the enemy choose a lot of HP heroes, Kerri is your pick if you want to counter them. Then the last hero on this list is Leslie. Leslie is also a marksman that has high basic attack damage and is able to attack from a big distance, just like Layla. The biggest difference is that Leslie has a decent mobility for a marksman hero. Her first skill increases her movement speed and makes her untargetable, while she can use her second skill to shoot an enemy away when coming closely. I prefer choosing Leslie over Layla when the enemy has some heroes that can easily come close, since this is a big weakness of Layla. Leslie also has to pay attention to stay alive, but it's just a lot easier with skill 1 and 2. So if you need a long range marksman, while the enemy team consists of heroes that can easily come close to you, Leslie might be a better pick. Also, her increased movement speed helps her to move through the map quickly. This makes it easier to walk towards another lane to gank. Leslie's ultimate is also useful when your team has some high burst damage heroes. They can erase the biggest part of their HP and Leslie is able to finish it with her sniper. I suggest you use Leslie if the enemy has heroes that are weak against long range heroes like Chang'e, Kerri, Bruno, Eudora and almost all fighters. Like I said, she goes well with high burst damage heroes. Therefore, you can choose her when your allies play heroes like Cecilian, Kadita, Guinevere, Jawhead, Hayabusa, Vale and Helkert. Leslie is weak against heroes with high defense and HP. Also, the very high mobility assassins can be strong against her. Be careful when the enemy picks heroes like Fanny, Hayabusa, Ling and Basha. Overall, she's just a strong marksman that has to farm in early game to dominate in late game. These were the 5 best marksman heroes. I hope this information helped you to choose the right hero in the right situation. If you want to increase your win rate, this is a very important factor. If you like this kind of guides and want to learn more tips and tricks about how to increase your win rate, consider to subscribe to the channel. I'll do my best to increase your gameplay by providing valuable content. Thank you for watching and I'll be seeing you in the next guide.